This is the coming together of a large number of people at every level, including those that are just getting into the field at the undergrad level.
I needed to come to a place that had these kind of facilities.
Nanotechnology and quantum computing are technologies of the current and the future.
The new building contains a wide variety of labs. It's interdisciplinary in nature, everything from nanobiotechnology to fabrication facilities for the MEMS and nanostructured devices.
It serves as sort of a foundry for creating nanodevices and inventing new nanotechnologies.
There is nowhere else in the world where a large institute for nanotechnology is co-located with one of the world's leading centers for quantum computing.
That building's going to bring together an incredible number of students. And so to have, you know, students in quantum information exposed more strongly to nanotechnology and vice versa, I think there's a lot of potential there for students kind of discovering an intersection of fields that they didn't really know existed before.
There are not only faculty members, there are graduate students, masters and PhD, and postdoctoral fellows, but there are also 500 undergraduate students from the Nanotechnology Engineering program. This is the largest undergraduate program in nanotechnology in North America.
I think the undergrad students will be a lot more involved in research if we're all in the same building and in close proximity to each other.
There's going to be a lot more equipment, it's going to be really high tech, so we're going to be pushing the limits of, you know, nanofabrication.
We're very proud of the building, we're very proud of what's going to be in it, and we know that this is going to have a tremendous effect on society in the years ahead.
We'll get surprises. That's why we put these people together. That's why we have those creative minds going into those labs right now. This is a very interesting time.